同学们好，今天我们来学习第137课 Lesson 137 A Pleasant Dream. We'll look at a story about a couple who are dreaming about the football pools. 一对夫妇正在谈论赢了足球赛的赌注之后他们想做的事情。一起来看课文并且回答这样一个问题。
What would Julie like to do if she had the money?
如果 Julie 有那笔钱她想要做什么呢？
Are you doing the football pools, Brian?
Yes, I've nearly finished, Julie. I'm sure we'll win something this week.
You always say that, but we never win anything. What will you do if you win a lot of money?
If I win a lot of money, I'll buy you a mink coat.
I don't want a mink coat.I want to see the world.
All right. If we win a lot of money, we'll travel around the world and we'll stay at the best hotels. Then we'll return home and buy a big house in the country. We'll have a beautiful garden and...
But if we spend all that money, we'll be poor again. What will we do then?
If we spend all the money, we'll try and win the football pools again.
It's a pleasant dream, but everything depends on if.
现在请大家回答这个问题。What would Julie like to do if she had the money?
She would like to travel and see the world.
如果有这笔钱 ,Julie 想去周游世界见见世面。好，下面一起来看本课中的关键词和词组，请跟我读。
Keywords and expressions.
Football. 我们知道在美语当中 ,football 的意思是橄榄球，足球呢是 soccer.
Pool.
Football pools. 足球赛赌注。
Win.
Win 是一个不规则动词，它的过去式和过去分词分别是 won, won.
World.Depend on.
一起来看课文中的主要语言点。
Are you doing the football pools, Brian?
Yes, I've nearly finished, Julie.
Brian, 你正在下足球赛赌注吗？是的，我这就做完了。
Do the football pools.
下足球赛赌注。Do 这个动词的用法比较灵活，它可以和很多的名词构成短语，翻译的方法也各不相同。比如说
,Do the dishes.
这就相当于 wash the dishes, 洗碗。Do the cooking, 也就相当于 cook, 做饭。
Brian 说 I'm sure we'll win something this week.
我肯定这个星期我们将赢点什么。
Win, 赢得。比如说 She won first prize in the competition.
在比赛中她得了一等奖。
David won the race.
David 在赛跑或者赛车当中获胜。
You always say that, but we never win anything.
你总是那么说，但是我们从来就没有赢过。
Never, 从未。
来看两个例句。
He has never been abroad.
他从来没有出过国。
I'll never do that.
我永远不会那么做。
Never,
在形式上是肯定的，但是它表示的意思却是否定的。接着 ,Brian 和 Julie 两人就开始梦想起来。想着如果足球赛赌注赢了，他们将做些什么事情。
What will you do if you win a lot of money?
如果你赢了很多钱，你将做些什么？请大家注意 ,if 的意思是如果，这是一个表示条件的状语从句。从句当中使用的是一般现在时，而主句中使用的是一般将来时。
A lot of,
许多。我们还可以说 lots of。A lot of 既可以修饰可数名词，也可以修饰不可数名词。比如说
,I've got a lot of time.
我有很多的时间。
He received a lot of presents.
他收到了很多的礼物。Time 是不可数名词 ,present 是可数名词。Brian 说如果我赢了钱我就会为你买一件貂皮大衣。
If I win a lot of money, I'll buy you a mink coat.
就像我们刚才所说的If 所引导的从句中我们使用一般现在时而在主句中呢要使用一般将来时。
Buy you a mink coat.
给你买一件貂皮大衣。
Buy somebody something.
或者我们还可以说 Buy something for somebody.
比如
给我买一本书。
Buy me a book.
或者 Buy a book for me.
但是 Julie 并不想要貂皮大衣。
I don't want a mink coat.
Then what does she want?
I want to see the world.
我想要去见见世面。
一起来看看 Brian 和 Julie 的梦想。
If we win a lot of money, we'll travel around the world and we'll stay at the best hotels.
如果我们赢了很多钱，我们就去周游世界。我们还可以待在最好的酒店里。
Travel around the world,
周游世界。刚才所说的 see the world, 见见世面。
Tour the world,
也是周游世界的意思。
Stay at the best hotels,
住在最好的酒店里。之后他们将做什么呢？
Then we'll return home and buy a big house in the country.
然后我们就回家，在乡下买一栋大房子。
Return home,
回家，也就相当于 come back home.
In the country,
也就是 in the countryside, 在乡下。
Country 有乡下或者国家的意思，
比如说 Which country are you from?
你是从哪个国家来的？你是哪国人？
We'll have a beautiful garden and
我们将会有一个漂亮的花园，以及
看到 Brian 这样的做梦， Julie 实在有点忍不住了，于是她问
But if we spend all that money, we'll be poor again. What will we do then?
但是如果我们把所有的钱都花光了，我们又会变穷了，然后我们该怎么做呢？
Brian 是这样回答的 If we spend all the money, we'll try and win the football pools again.
如果我们花光了所有的钱，我们就设法在足球赛赌注上再赢一次。在口语中，我们常常用 try and 来代替 try to. 比如说
I'll try and phone tomorrow.
明天我设法再打电话。
Try and get a seat.
试着去找一个座位。
It's a pleasant dream, but everything depends on if.
这是一个美好的梦，但是一切都取决于如果，也就是说一切都是不真实的。
Everything depends on if,
我们还可以说 It all depends on if.
Depend on,
取决于或者是依靠。来看两个例句。
The result depends on our efforts.
结果取决于我们的努力。
We depend on the radio for news.
我们依靠收音机来获得消息。在学习了课文的主要语言点之后，我们来总结一下本课的基本句型。
If,
如果。
If the children come home early, they'll play in the garden.
如果孩子们回家早，他们就会在花园里玩。
I'll tell him the truth if he asks me.
如果他问我，那么我就会告诉他事实。
If 引导条件状语从句，
它既可以放在句首，也可以放在主句的后面。在 if 所引导的从句中，常用一般现在时，而在主句中，常用一般将来时。也就是说，只有这件事情发生之后，另外一件事情将会发生或者才会发生。下面我们再来看一遍课文，请大家跟读，并且特别注意Brian 和 Julie 是怎样谈论如果赢了足球赛的赌注，他们将会做些什么。
Are you doing the football pools, Brian?
Yes, I've nearly finished, Julie. I'm sure we'll win something this week.
You always say that, but we never win anything. What will you do if you win a lot of money?
If I win a lot of money...I'll buy you a mink coat.
I don't want a mink coat. I want to see the world.
All right. If we win a lot of money, we'll travel around the world and we'll stay at the best hotels. Then we'll return home and buy a big house in the country. We'll have a beautiful garden and...
But if we spend all that money, we'll be poor again.What will we do then?
If we spend all the money, we'll try and win the football pools again.
It's a pleasant dream, but everything depends on if.
接下来我们进入句型训练，来练习一下如何表达假如某事发生，另外一件事情将会发生。
Lesson 138, if. Break this window, pay for it.What will we do if we break this window? If you break this window, you'll have to pay for it.
Hurry, miss the train.
What will happen if I don't hurry? If you don't hurry, we'll miss the train.
Fall, hurt himself.
What will happen if he falls?If he falls, he'll hurt himself.
Rain, go to the seaside.
What'll we do if it rains tomorrow? If it rains tomorrow, we won't go to the seaside.
尽管 tomorrow 指的是将来的某个时间，但是在 if 所引导的从句当中，我们常用一般现在时 if it rains tomorrow.
Come home early. Play in the garden.
What will the children do if they come home early?
If they come home early, they'll play in the garden.
Feel better. Get up.
What can I do if I feel better?
If you feel better, you can get up. 情态动词 can 的现在时既可以指现在，又可以指将来。
Sell the car, buy a new one.
What can he do if he sells that car?
If he sells that car, he can buy a new one.
Rich, have a long holiday.
What can she do if she is rich?
If she is rich,She can have a long holiday. 今天我们学习了如何来表达假如实现了某件事情，另外一件事情就会发生，也就是如何来使用条件状语从句。如果我们所询问或者谈论的事情很有可能发生，那么从句中常用一般现在时，而主句中呢，则用一般将来时。含有 if 的从句既可以放在句首，也可以放在主句的后面。但是如果我们所谈论的事情不太有可能发生，那么就要使用虚拟语气，大家会在以后的学习中学到。好了，今天的课就到这儿了。 Thank you and see you next time.
My U 网 www.moreedu.com My U 给您更多的学习。